Hey, what is going on, everybody out there? This is Jake James Lugo from thecoalition.com. I am at E3 2018, and I got some more cool surprises for you guys, as I always do. Right now, I'm going to be talking about Jump Force for you guys. It was recently just revealed not too long ago. It was an awesome reveal. We got to see the trailer, got to play a little bit not too long ago, which we'll talk about some other time. But I got some special guests with me right now for this interview. I got Koji Nakajima from Bandai Namco, as well as also Yuji Moriya from also from Bandai Namco. They're here to talk with me about Jump Force. Gentlemen, welcome. It's a pleasure to at least to talk to you guys. How's everything going so far?
Yeah,
so for E3, you know, we got to announce this big game, and you know, we got a lot of positive feedback and a lot of excitement out of it. So yeah, I'm very pleased and very honored, very happy about that.
Yes, me, and again, I just love checking it out. I got to play the game a little bit. Got to play with some of the characters that you guys showed in the trailer that was also in the gameplay as well. Tell me a little bit about Jump Force, you know, for people that are just probably discovering this for the first time, you know, just hearing about it, you know, probably haven't even seen the trailer. What is Jump Force exactly?
Jump Force とはズバリ何でしょう？
はい、本作は週刊少年ジャンプという日本で、素晴らしい作品を生み出し続ける、漫画雑誌の50周年を記念したとても、スペシャルな、タイトルになります。
So this title is a very special title that is going to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Shonen Jump magazine series.
Awesome. And again, I've been a fan of Shonen Jump. I've watched a lot of the shows that have come out over the years and stuff. I mean, you guys got some iconic characters for a lot of people. That's pretty awesome. What are, like, you know, some of the special things about, you know, fans that are like really hardcore into this type of stuff really going to notice? I mean, granted, you got some of their favorite characters like Goku, you got Naruto, and the list goes on. But I also noticed that the world's a little bit different than like previous anime games that they might have appeared in. I mean, what is some of the stuff that the people are really going to get excited about this time?
Well, このゲームで一番注目すべきものって何ですか？まあ、特にまあ、世界観とかすごく、まあ、前作と比べて全然違うんですけど、はい、ちょっと、はい、どういうところを注目した
らいいか。本作は、まあ、通常のキャラクターの作品のクロスオーバー作品とは全く、異なるアプローチをしてまして、まあ、作品ごとのクロスオーバーだけではなくて、まあ、ジャンプと、現実、リアルの、まあ、クロスオーバーにも、チャレンジ、している作品です。
So first of all, unlike our other, you know, previous games, other crossover games that we've done, this is a completely new approach. So instead of just, you know, crossing over titles amongst themselves, we're actually crossing over into a new realm, which is our world. It's the real world versus the manga and anime world. So that's something that's very fresh and new.
でまあ、これまではやはり漫画とか、アニメの作品をどうゲームで再現するかっていうようなアプローチでゲームの方を作ってるんですけど、今回は全く新しいアプローチで、漫画とかアニメのものをじゃあリアルに持ってきた時に、どういう表現になるのかとか、まあ、どういう体験ができるのかっていうのを、まあ、皆さんに、楽しんでいただきたいと思っている作品です。
Yeah, so I think the most exciting part is that, you know, in the past games, you know, we were really focused on recreating that anime experience in the video game context. But what we're trying to do here is we're trying to take what's in the manga and adapt it in the real world and have this unique experience. So I think that's something that the fans should look forward to, definitely.
Again, and it shows. When I first saw it, I was blown away at how pretty it looked, how things looked really, really great. Now, what my thing that I'm curious about is that, you know, a lot of these different characters, they are very exaggerated in the way that they're designed. You know, some of their special moves, they're really over the top and stuff. Was there ever a worry that, like, you know, certain things might not translate well to, you know, to the real world? Like, you know, again, bringing these types of characters to our world, you know, there's not the same types of, like, physics, not the same types of, like, you know, aesthetic here and there. But was there ever a worry about that when you were designing the game?
まあ、このゲームデザインしている過程の中でやっぱりキャラクターっていうのはすごい派手でやっぱすごい激しいまあアクションや技を繰り広げると思うんですけれども、例えばまあこのキャラまあなんかのキャラクターをまあこのリアリティを出したいと思った時にやっぱこれはちょっとすごい再現するの難しいなっていうのはなんかありました？
そうですね、まあ、全体的にもともと 2D 漫画とかアニメのものを、まあ、3D のリアルの世界に持ってくるっていうところで、まあ、単純に持ってきただけですととてもなんか違和感があるとかちょっと人形っぽいみたいな、ところがあったので、それを、いかに、リアルの世界に馴染ませるかっていうのが、まあ、一つチャレンジでした。
So one of the challenges, yes, as you said, it is a huge challenge for us to bring something from the 2D realm to this like 3D realistic world. So when we try to adapt something from the manga as is and try to just put it in this sort of context, it does get very dull and sort of like very doll-like in a sense.
例えばルフィ の本来は漫画ではルフィの上の服は布でできているんですけれども、まあ、今作、まあ、リアルな世界に持ってくるにあたり、レザーのような、装飾にしてよりその光が当たった時の質感とかがきちんと出るような、まあ、独自の、まあ、解釈といいますか工夫をして今回1キャラクター1キャラクター作っています。
So in order to make the characters more appealing in this sort of real-world graphic approach is, for example, in Luffy, in the manga, supposedly his vest, his shirt is made out of cloth or like some sort of a cotton material. But when we try to translate that into our game, it looks a little too bland, right? So what we did, instead of making it sort of out of cloth or any sort of like cotton, we actually made it into a more leather-like texture, and so that when at light in certain lighting and angles, it sort of gives off a little bit of shine. So that's another that's one detail that we sort of had to modify in order to fit the character from the manga into this real-world sort of graphic direction.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question, because that was stuff that I noticed, you know, playing the game, watching the trailer and stuff, and it looks very cool, it looks very interesting. Again, it's a little bit of a different way of seeing some of these characters, you know, being translated into the real world. What were some of the challenges, you know, like you explained with Luffy, were there ever ones, you know, certain characters that were maybe really difficult, but like you guys came up with clever ways to kind of, you know, present them still in their original form, but, you know, still translate well into this world?
その、まあ、服のこと以外になんかやっぱりこのキャラクターはやっぱ実現するのがすごく難しかったとか、まあ、このキャラクターは本当にこういうアレンジを しないとやっぱり、何ですか、 3D に、まあ、移転することが、まあ、すごい難しかったっていうのはなんかありますか？
そうですね、まあ、一つ、もう一つで言うと例えばナルトのクラマ、超必殺を使った時に出てくるクラマなんですけども、これは、割とその現実のなんていうんですかね、ふさふさ感というか、まあ、毛皮感というのをきちんと出しながら全体的にこう、まあ、エフェクトを当てるような形にしてすごくその存在感を出しています。やはりそのまま持ってくるとなんていうのか、こうかき割りみたいなような、 なんか合成みたいな風に見えてしまわないように、そういった工夫をして、実際派手な絵っていうのを実現しています。
So another example, I guess, in Naruto, his ultimate awakening special move is featuring Ninetales. Ninetales, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Yeah. So Ninetales, we added, we had to make sure that, his the Ninetales' fur was there and very detailed in this real world rendering. So if we try to, sort of recreate the manga as is, it probably gonna get a little like blocky and like very composited. So we tried to avoid that. So our own arrangement, and we wanted to really focus on that detail and give Ninetales that really furry, nice texture.
Awesome. Now, speaking of Ninetales, speaking of special abilities, I mean, the awakening for pretty much every character. I saw Naruto had the Ninetales, Goku goes Super Saiyan, Luffy changes his form. Obviously, all the different characters have their signature looks and powers to them. I mean, when you guys were choosing the roster and, going through all these characters, were there like certain things that you felt like you had to pick, like because the fan base just would love to see stuff like that?
まあ、いろんな、キャラクターが参戦してて、いろんなそういった、まあ、覚醒技っていうのがあると思うんですけど、やっぱりキャラクター選定の中でやっぱこれは絶対、逃しちゃいけないなって思ったキャラクターって言いますか？
そうですね、まあ、今回ゲームを作る上でこれを入れたらお客さん、ファンの皆さんびっくりするなっていう作品はあります。ただまだ初出の段階なので現時点ではお伝えできないんですけれども、ぜひ皆さんこの後の情報の、まあ、アナウンスっていうのを楽しみにしてもらえればと思います。
Unfortunately, I can't really dive too much into the details about characters and what's coming up and stuff. But yes, we do have the audience in mind when we're trying to implement characters. Something that the character or the fan base would absolutely want to see in the game. So we will be coming out with further announcements and announcing these characters, so please look forward to our future announcements.
And then a final spin-off of that, I mean, looking at some of these characters, they fight in various different ways. They have a lot of different fighting styles. They have a lot of different powers and stuff. I mean, was it a challenge trying to make sure that you guys hit, like, all the notes and had, like, you know, signature moves like Goku has the Kamehameha, Naruto has the duplicate, the clones and stuff? Was it challenging to kind of get, like, a whole bunch of moves for, like, every single character, or did you have to pick and choose certain ones at some point?
やっぱりそのキャラクターをまあデザインするにあたってやっぱりいろんなまあまあ有名な技とか必殺技とかあると思うんですけど、そういったものを全てやっぱきめ細かく再現するのはやっぱり難しかったですか。であとやっぱあのどうしてもまあこれはまあ全部入れたいけどまあちょっと妥協しなきゃいけないっていう部分もあったんでしょうか。
そうですね、まあ必殺技に関してはちょっとまあ皆さんすごくこう注意してみないと分かんないかもしれないんですけども、例えばカメハメハも実は単純に青い光がバーってまっすぐ飛んでいるんじゃなくて、その中に流線が入っているような形で、きちんとその実際に持ってきた時に、存在感が出るような、工夫もしています。で1キャラ1キャラ、そういった、工夫っていうのをして、今回のゲームのキャラクターを、作っています。で、まあ、妥協をしているポイント、まあ、そのあたりは妥協せずに、ずっとブラッシュアップし続けてるんですけども、まあ、やっぱりこうジャンプ50周年でいろんなたくさん作品がありまして、僕もたくさん好きな作品いっぱいあるんですけど、やっぱ全部入れることができないと。でそこはやっぱり僕らにとってはとても心苦しいというか、本当はもっともっとたくさん、まあ、ファンの皆さんもたくさんたくさんもう全部入れてくれっていうのが、まあ、多分願いだとは思うんですけど、まあ、そこはやっぱりこうどうしても、まあ、そういう作り方をしているんで、なかなか実現することはできないというところですね。
Yeah, so in terms of special moves, I think we do pretty well to try to represent the characters, but I think if you look even closer and check out the details, you will notice even further like our arrangements that the, the modifications that we put in. So like Kamehameha, it's not in the game, it's probably just like a beam of light, a beam of boom light, blue light. But in the game, if you look closely, you can see like inside the beam, there's like a dragon in there. So that's something to look forward to and kind of be excited about. So it's not like all the same, but it adds a nice little touch to it. In terms of compromises that we had to make, obviously, the Shonen Jump series has been going on for 50 years. There's so many things that, we could potentially put on it. But obviously, yes, we had to cut down on some things just because, the time it takes to put a character and adapt it into this sort of real world illustration. So yeah, while I would love to put everything and everything into this game, we do have to compromise, and all the ones that didn't make it, it hurts me even to not be able to put those in. But yeah, definitely.
And speaking of which, I mean, talking about the real world in this case, I know during the trailer and even when I got to play the game, noticing some real world locations, some famous places, famous locations that people would recognize offhand. I mean, tell us a little bit about the process you guys had to go through to pick certain, like, locations that people would love to see these characters fight in.
まあ、いろんな現実のロケーションを使った、まあ、ステージを、まあ、あるステージがあるんですけれども、まあ、どういう、ステージを、まあ、決めるか、どういうところを、フィーチャーするかっていうのを、まあ、選定するまでの、その、まあ、過程というか、まあ、プロセスをちょっと、触れていただけますか。
そうですね、やっぱり今回、まあ、リアルな世界っていうふうに、を考えている、まあ、そのコンセプトですので、まあ、いろんなまあ、風景とかいろんなシーン、全く別の場所に行けば別のシーンが見れるっていうような形で、ステージの選定っていうのをしています。また今回、全世界のファンに向けて同時にこのゲームを楽しんでもらいたいっていうふうに、僕らは考えているので、よりそのどっかの場所に集中しているというより もう全体世界の中で、どういった場所があるかっていうのを見ながら、選定をしています。
So in terms of location, obviously we want to include a lot of various scenery, the change up, the mood, the atmosphere and all that. So we try to include a wide spectrum of this sort of scenery in our stage when we choose our location. And also, this game is meant for a same time, simultaneous release worldwide. And this is a game for the worldwide audience. So we try to keep that in mind and make sure that the locations we pick are not lopsided to a single region. region or a single hemisphere or anything like that. We try to go across the globe and make sure that the world in its, not entirely, but a wide location is covered.
There's a lot of variety, a lot of representation from all over the place, which is because there's a lot of fans all over the world for this. So that's pretty interesting. So one final question, again, it's pretty basic, pretty simple. I mean, again, you mentioned 50 years Shonen Jump. I mean, well, pretty much 50 years of Jump, 50 years of these characters, so many stories, so many crazy things, so many Easter eggs here and there. Is there like little things probably here and there that a lot of fans that have probably been following these stories for many years are going to notice? I mean, again, you guys had a tease at the very end for the certain character with a special book and some stuff. But like, I mean, is there going to be other stuff that real hardcore fans, you know, real meta fans are really going to get that they'll pick up that maybe, you know, might be a little harder to spot at first glance?
ジャンプ50周年ということで、まあ、いろんなこう、まあ、タイトルがあっていろんなストーリーがあったりして、あの、まあ、やり続けたジャンプなんですけども、このでそのそれを、まあ、お祭りとしてそれを、まあ、記念したゲームということなんですけども、まあ、そのゲームの中に、まあ、いろんなネタとか多分か隠し要素っていうのはやっぱ見つけられるんですけど、やっぱりあの結構長い間読み続けてる人はやっぱにしかこうあの分からないとかそういったなんか隠し要素とかネタとかやっぱり、期待できるんでしょう。
そうですね、まあ、今回、ファンの皆さんに、楽しんで、まあ、単純に対戦だけじゃなくてですね、ファンの皆さんに楽しんでいただきたい要素っていうのはあるので、ちょっとそこはきちんとそういったネタも入れるようにしてます、まあ、もしか今回のビルドもですね、もしかしたらファンには分かりやすいかもしれないんですけども、まあ、例えばマッターホルンには実はこのサイヤ人の宇宙ポッドがボンと転がってたりとか、そういうステージにもそういう遊び心を入れてますので、ぜひ皆さん楽しみに無視してもらえればと思います。
Yeah, so you know, this game we're not trying to do make it just like a purely an action fighting game, right? We want the fans to really enjoy and really immerse themselves in this new atmosphere, this really unique a collision of this world. So yeah, definitely we're gonna have a lot of Easter eggs in there. And in the demo, for example, it might be a little bit more obvious right now just because it's an initial demo release. But you may have noticed in Matterhorn, you saw a space ball, like the Saiyan space ball, just kind of laying there, just crash landed, so that sort of thing, you can expect to see a lot of in this game.
I can't wait. I mean, it's going to be really, really fun seeing a lot of these characters come together and a lot of other cool stuff with it. So, gentlemen, thank you for chatting up with me. Really, it was a pleasure and stuff. Is there any release window when, as far as the game's coming out?
リリースのタイミングって、もし、分かれば教えてください。
現在もう発表させていただいたんですけども、まあ、2019年に皆さんにお届けしようというふうに、考えてます。
So our current plan is in 2019 is the current announcement right now.
Awesome. Can't wait to play more. Thank you guys for chatting up with me. Guys, I will be back again very soon with some more stuff from E3 2018. Hope to talk to you guys again real soon. Peace out and stay epic, everybody.